Good day all. In this session, we are going to discuss about spermatogenesis in the animated pattern. Let's see. First of all, let's define what is spermatogenesis. The process of formation of a motile sperm from the spermatogonia is what is called as spermatogenesis. And unlike oogenesis, spermatogenesis begins just before puberty and continues throughout the adult life with a decline in the old age. Here, before seeing the actual process of spermatogenesis, let me brief the formation of spermatogonia from the primordial germ cells. In the previous sessions, we have seen by 6th week, the PG cells invade the gonads. And by 7th week, the PG cells induce the indifferent gonads to differentiate into a testis or ovary depends upon the sex of the embryo. So, differentiation in gonads begin by 7th week. In the male embryo, by 7th week, the surface epithelial cells, nothing but the future Sertoli cells, arrange themselves around the PG cells and form card-like structures. These card-like structures are called as primitive sex cards. These primitive sex cards extend from the cortex to the medulla of the developing testis. Unlike the female embryo, in male, the cortical cards degenerate and only the medullary cards are retained. Around 4th month, the medullary cards arrange themselves into horseshoe-shaped structures, and now the mesenchymal cells present around this region get converted into peritubular myoid cells and they form a few layers around the horseshoe-shaped medullary cards. Now this structure is called as seminiferous cards. On screen, you can see a section of the developing testis showing the seminiferous cords with the PG cells in the center surrounded by large Sertoli cells resting on the basement membrane covered by peritubular myoid cells. This whole structure will wait until puberty to proceed further. Shortly before puberty, due to hormonal changes, the solid seminiferous cords acquire a lumen and become the seminiferous tubules. At the same time, the PG cells also converted into spermatogonial stem cells. Now, the newly formed seminiferous tubules are lined with spermatogonial stem cells and large Sertoli cells resting on the basement membrane and covered with peritubular myoid cells. Each seminiferous tubule has a lumen in the center, and in between the seminiferous tubules in the interstitium presents the Leydig cells. And the formation of spermatogonial stem cells initiate the process of spermatogenesis. Let's see the process of spermatogenesis. Spermatogenesis includes three stages. Stage 1 is called as spermatocytogenesis, the genesis of a spermatocyte. Here, the diploid pale type A spermatogonia is converted into haploid secondary spermatocyte. Stage 2 is called as spermatidogenesis, the genesis of a spermatid. And this stage says about the formation of a round haploid spermatid from the haploid secondary spermatocyte. Stage 3 is called as spermiogenesis, the genesis of a motile sperm. This stage says about the cytodifferentiation of a round non-motile spermatid into a motile sperm or spermatozoan. Actually, in this session, I'll discuss about the first stage alone, that is the stage of spermatocytogenesis. Stages 2nd and 3rd will be discussed later as spermatogenesis part 2. First, let's see about stage 1, the spermatocytogenesis.
This is a process of formation of a haploid secondary spermatocyte from the diploid pale type A spermatogonia. This stage includes the formation of a series of different types of spermatogonia by mitotic division and then the formation of secondary spermatocyte by meiotic division. This stage includes two substages. They are the mitotic phase and the meiotic phase. The mitotic phase brings about 7 mitotic divisions and takes a minimum of 16 days. And the meiotic phase takes a minimum of 24 days. As a whole, spermatocytogenesis takes a minimum of 40 days to get completed. First, let's see the substage 1. The mitotic phase. From puberty at regular intervals, a group of spermatogonial stem cells, that is the dark type A spermatogonial cells, divide by mitotic division and give rise to one dark type A spermatogonia and one pale type A spermatogonia. The dark type A spermatogonia will be kept as reserve for the next cycle of spermatogenesis. And the pale type A spermatogonia enters into the actual process of spermatogenesis. This pale type A spermatogonia undergoes around 5 consecutive mitotic divisions and produce pale type A clone cells. At the 6th mitotic division, each pale type A spermatogonia will give rise to 2 dark type B spermatogonia. And this dark type B spermatogonia undergoes one more mitotic division and forms 2 primary spermatocytes. All the cells produced in this phase are diploid in nature as they are undergoing only mitotic division. And the primary spermatocyte produced at the end will enlarge in size and prepare itself for the meiotic division. The second substage under spermatocytogenesis is the meiotic phase and it takes around 24 days. In this period, the diploid primary spermatocyte thus formed will complete the first meiotic division and give rise to 2 haploid secondary spermatocytes. So, at the end of stage 1, each pale type A spermatogonia give rise to roughly around 256 secondary spermatocytes with haploid number of chromosomes, that is 23 chromosomes. And the secondary spermatocyte thus formed has completed the first meiotic division and proceed towards the second meiotic division. I will discuss the continuation of this process later as spermatogenesis part 2. Till then, bye.